We have been waiting for years for somebody to come along who looks to the people as being genuine, sensible, and prepared to fight to the bitter end. That man is Jeremy Corbyn. He's your man, and all the others around him. We can't fail. We're on a winner. Thank you very much. And here is your new leader.
We live in a world that has become more and more unequal. 6 years of frozen wages in the public sector, 6 years of underinvestment in housing, 6 years of underfunding of the health service. We're left with problem after problem after problem.
Our campaign will improve social justice and equality within this country. Our campaign will change the way we look at the world and our status in this world. And our campaign will ensure that no one, no community, and no area of this country is ever forgotten, ignored, or left behind ever again. Thank you very much.
It's been betrayed by this government with the increase in tuition fees, the scrapping of educational maintenance allowance, and now the attack on maintenance grants and the cuts in education generally. Education is a gift from one generation to another. It is not a product, a commodity to be bought and sold. For generations now, one generation has handed the baton on to the next. It's tried to ensure that the next generation has a better quality of life than the last. This government is betraying you and future generations. We need to oppose it, and I'm here in solidarity with that opposition. Let me say this. Your voice needs to be heard. This will be a peaceful demonstration, and stay safe. But make sure the politicians know that we're not going to stand for this anymore. Education is a basic human right. It is not something to be bought and sold. This generation will teach these Tories that we will not stand by and allow them to destroy your futures. Solidarity! Solidarity!
We live in a country where we have a tradition of a national health service. We have a tradition of a welfare state. We have a tradition of the idea that there should be a safety net for all of us. But I see massive holes in that safety net, and I see massive inequality. Is a society happy if a minority can afford to buy a Ferrari and a Maserati or a McLaren and drive slowly past those who are sleeping on the street because there's nowhere for them to live? Once the genie is out of the bottle, once the determination of all of us together to bring about that better society, to ensure that those with disabilities are not poor and discriminated against, those with difficulties with mental health are not discriminated against, those living in poverty can see some light at the end of the tunnel. That is the strength of this movement. That is the strength of all of us when we come together.
What is it about Tory Britain? Too many children being brought up in grossly overcrowded, badly maintained, expensive, damp, short-term, private rented accommodation across this country. It was the Tories under Thatcher that started the destruction of council housing and instead replacing it with a free market dogma. I tell you this, I want a Labour government that says our priority is to ensure by the end of that first term of that government, everyone is decently, securely and properly housed within our society.
When we go back into government, there'll be no more Google deals where they only pay a tenth of what they owe. We'll make sure those who are implicated in the Panama leaks are brought to book, and we'll close down the tax havens, and we'll stop the City of London being used at possibly one of the largest tax havens on the globe. That will be our fair taxation system.
Can we run politics by allowing an elite to decide what the politics should be, an elite to decide what the policies are, an elite to decide all the decisions we make, or is it to be the participation of the hundreds of thousands of people that are now part of our party and our movement? There is so much we can achieve if we open our minds to the possibilities of what can be done. A society where no one and no community is ever forgotten or left behind. Thank you very much.
We can only develop as a democratic society if all our young people are brought up and grow up understanding where our rights have come from, understanding where our achievements have come from. They were never handed down from above. The NHS was never a gift. It was something achieved from the ground upwards. In a real democracy, it's not just about voting every 4 or 5 years. It's not just about electing people to public office. It's holding them to account when they are in public office, but having your say at all other times on what policies are going to go forward and be developed. Decisions taken top down end up working for the benefit of the privileged few, not the many. Perhaps we could turn that thing around. We need to have decision making made for the millions and not the millionaires. That surely would be a right way of doing things.
Europe. But I also want us to be the new tech centre of Europe as well. And that means, again, that long-term investment. But above all else as well, if we're going to have a share in this prosperity for everybody, that means, yes, fairness at work. How do you achieve fairness at work? Well, you know. It's about ensuring that we have trade union rights. All we're asking for in this country is for a government to abide by the ILO conventions to enable us to have trade union freedom once again. But I tell you this, we've seen the onslaught on trade unionism over the last 6 years under a Tory government and a coalition government dominated by Tories. And it's produced an existential threat to trade unionism in the Trade Union Act, which will undermine fairness at work, undermine the ability of working people to share in the prosperity as we grow our economy. So in the first 100 days of a Labour government, we will scrap the Trade Union Act. It will go.
Our campaign is about democracy within the Labour movement and the Labour Party. It is about thinking about things differently, but above all, it's about the empowerment of people.
We don't want every school to be a competitor and a school down the road. Not divide our children in learning, but make sure every one of them gets the best education, whatever their abilities are, at any age. Bringing in the traditions of our movement, the strengths of our movement, the values of our movement, put them out there, because they're basically decent, good human values. That is what will defeat injustice. That is what will defeat inequality. That is what will bring about real opportunities for everybody in our society. Thank you very much.